Well, America, it's happened. We have a new president. And unfortunately, not the president that I voted for. Unfortunately, the majority of the residents of the United States of America have decided that a man that thinks it's okay to grab a woman by the pussy and that wants to just nuke the hell out of them and throws temper tantrums when he doesn't get his way. Who has filed for bankruptcy on multiple occasions, who had a fictitious school that he built people out of money, that doesn't feel that it is right to pay people for the work that they've done. We have this person as our commander in chief. America is fucked. And if by some reason or by some miracle he actually manages to do a good job, then I'll acknowledge that. But I honestly feel like crying that we have this many people in our country that think that this man will actually do a good job, when if anyone had gotten the opportunity to, well, or if anybody actually paid attention to the things that he has said and done. I mean, mocking a handicapped person at one of his rallies, a reporter that has a physical disability, he mocked them. This is the man that we elected as our leader, a man that objectifies women and that has no respect for anyone but himself. We have this many people in our country that think that this is the man that we want to lead us, and we think he's going to make a good leader. I'm very disillusioned now that he has become our commander in chief. President Trump, God help us all. I'm literally in tears that this man has become our president. God help us. God help us, because we can't help ourselves. This is probably, and I really, really, really hope I'm wrong, but this is going to be the downfall of our country. God help us all, because we can't even help ourselves. I don't understand. I just cannot comprehend that there are so many people in our country that think that this man will do a good job of running our country when he can't even do a good job of running his own companies. I mean, where's the disconnect? There's a disconnect somewhere. I don't know where it is, and I'm very afraid for our country. I am very afraid for our country. If there was a way that, I could get into Canada really soon and get out of here, I really honestly think that, myself and my family would be moving to Canada. This is, oh my God, we've got an idiot as our president. Oh, God help us. God help. And I'm not a very religious person, you all know that, but I am praying for each and every one of us on a daily basis now, because I am, my God, people, what the fuck were you thinking? I mean, seriously, what the fuck were you all thinking electing this man to be our president? Seriously, what were you on thinking that this man's going to make a good president? What kind of an example does that show that someone who objectifies women the way he does and has, I mean, he honestly said if his daughter wasn't his daughter, he would date her. That means that he's physically attracted to his own child. I mean, how much more fucked up can you get? And this is the man you elected as our president. He wants to fuck his daughter. I mean, hello. But oh, we admire him. We think he would, we think he's the perfect person to be our president. Yeah, this man that says, just grab the woman by the pussy. Yeah, that's the person I want to have, representing the United States of America. Says that, just look at her, she's so gorgeous, and if she wasn't my daughter, really? Really? What message does this send to our daughters and our sons and our grandsons and our granddaughters that someone who has this attitude towards women, that this is okay, that this is the image that we are okay with our president having this opinion. We're okay with this. Wake up. Every last one of you that voted for him, I mean, you voted for him, and by voting for him, said, this is okay, and we approve of this opinion, and that we approve of him saying this. A woman that's flat-chested isn't pretty. If a woman's fat, she's not pretty. I mean, these are basically, his opinions. When he was building his casinos, he never paid everybody. I know people that worked on those buildings. Or no, well, I know people that know people. Well, I guess I know them because, if I know them, then I know. Regardless, he never paid for the work that was done. He started off paying, but then was like, oh no, I'm only going to give you this percentage. Well, no, you owe me this much. Well, we're only going to pay you this much. Well, they can't afford these little, the smaller companies can't afford all the lawyers and the legal fees to take this asshole to court for the money that's owed them. So they go and settle for the smaller amount for the job that they did when, they're still owed all this money. But that's okay. This is the man that you wanted as our president. So it's okay that he cheated these people out of money owed them. And wait a minute, he filed for bankruptcy four fucking times, meaning he doesn't know how to manage money properly. But that's okay. We're going to put this man in charge of our country's finances and make our national debt soar even higher. I think probably the only thing that I can see him doing right is possibly not sending money to countries overseas that, to countries that hate us, that would rather we ignore them and just leave them be, and actually maybe possibly keep the money in the country, which that's I don't know if that's, a realistic hope, but I think we're pretty much fucked. I think that we should all just, bend over, grab our ankles, and kiss our asses goodbye. I mean, Hillary wasn't the best choice either, but at least during her career, she has done a lot of good. She has focused on good things, about getting kids, making sure that, they have, medical coverage. Making sure that, things are done in the way they should. Well, not in the way they should, because, she's a little iffy too, but she was the lesser of two evils. And she at least has experience in the White House, literally. She lived there. But, she's for LGBTQ community and, wanting to give everyone equality, no matter, what race, color, race, religion, sexual orientation, whatever. She's for equality. Trump is not. What the fuck, people? I mean, seriously. And if you look at the demographics, it's like the uneducated, unemployed white male. Come on. Are y'all that really, are you really all that stupid? I'm like, I am so, I've ranted for 10 minutes now. I literally am like terrified for the safety of our country with this man as president. And we're stuck with him for 4 years, unless he's either assassinated or impeached. And I'm not going to say which one I would rather have happen, or if I should have, or I would want either to happen. I'm not going to do that. But it was a sad day in our country that this man has been elected as our president. I pray for us. I pray for us. I'm not religious, like I said, but I pray for the safety of our country. And he says, make America great again. I don't see it happening. But like I said, if by some miracle he actually pulls it off, I will concede that, you know what, maybe it wasn't a bad choice. But as of right now, God help us, America, because we can't even help ourselves.